Alright. I think we're getting set up here. Alright. And I can mute that. Don't need that. I was trying to test some levels earlier with a fan we got going in the window. Because the bedroom has to be freezing. Alright, let me get my squad list ready for this guy. Should be all saved up. Let me move everybody over. Welcome everybody, welcome, welcome. Probably have to adjust this angle here, but we'll have to work with it. I'm experimenting with a new camera angle for this X-Wing stuff. I don't know. I think it's kind of interesting to see the computer screen and stuff. I don't know. I'm going off based off feedback, and so far I haven't had any because we just started this whole thing earlier today with my first matchup. Now here we're here with the second, and we're about to get ready. Apparently I was a little earlier than I was thinking that I was supposed to be. So we're about to trade off lists. I just gotta get my link up. Alright, save. Didn't think I made any changes. It should all be the same. Let's just refresh this. Been having a heck of a time staying logged into my squadron builder for some reason. Ta-da-da-da-da. This one. Got it. Nope. Missed a letter. Okay. Just so everybody knows, I won't be reading chat. I don't want it to influence any of my play or anything like that. I'm trying to do everything legit. So, we're just tracking my progress through the Vassal League. I'll be providing as much commentary as I feel comfortable declaring. I'm about to exchange this here. If you're wondering why I'm doing something or what moves I'm selecting, I might not share everything just on the off chance that, you know, opponent might be watching the stream to kind of figure out what's going on in my head. As crazy as it is. Oh, that's a weird... That's a GitHub one, okay. Triple defenders. Haven't gone against these guys yet. But really, the X-Wing community is actually pretty awesome. There's not a whole lot of that kind of stuff going on. Everybody pretty much wants to help each other out and do everything legit. Got a Glaive Squadron, Countess Riot, Vessery. I haven't worked with this squad builder too much. Let me see if there's a better way to view this. Everybody's got Crackshot, everybody's got X7. And that's it. That's it for upgrades. Printer view is text. Let's try that. It's not terrible. Okay, let me, I'm gonna shrink this down. Bring this up. I'm trying to figure out the best way to show list and stuff too. Okay. So we've got mine. This isn't gonna work, I can already say that. Move it over here, maybe. Nope, the wrong screen. Actually, that works, though. Sorry, I'm figuring all this out on the fly. There's so many windows involved with Vassal. Okay, that's the right one. Subregion. Don't need all that. Da 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 ba dum. Should be good. And I move that over here. Okay, I just gotta scroll through it for you guys. So, he's running a Glaive Squadron Crackshot X7, Countess Ryad Crackshot X7, and a Vessery Crackshot X7. We don't have any pilot skill issues, so my 2-point bid is worthless. Alright. Move everything back. Get it out of the way. Again, I'm trying to figure out the best way to format everything and move you guys back to the map. Alright. So I'll go ahead and load my squad since we're just sitting here. I'm running Echo and Eugen. Just move all my guys, all my stuff over. And I'll keep Echo out. There we go. And then actually, I guess I want to move this over here so you guys don't get bothered by it. Spawn my damage deck. Alright, now we're just waiting on his stuff. So I need to leave Kallus out because I often forget to actually set it until, like, it's combat time. And then, like, nobody's had an issue with it, but now that I'm, like, playing in the league, I should, like, try to pretend I know what I'm doing. So, that's what we're doing here. I was not able to do this on my first match, but now that the kids are in bed, we're having a blue moon. Belgian White Ale. Delicious stuff. Okay, did he get his stuff in there? Okay, he did. Great. 98 points, not that it matters. Usually I only go for a 1-point bid, but going into the league format, I kind of wanted to have an extra point in there just because sometimes I get those 8s and the roll never goes my way, the roll for initiative. Hopefully everybody caught the first match. Tried to do a little brief introduction about X-Wing, but if you missed it, and this is something that's new, X-Wing is an awesome miniatures game. Definitely pick it up if you're interested in what you see. It's so much fun. Alright, so we'll figure out what side he wants. My division is pretty much made up of... He wants left side, alright. drain here. No. So, X-Wing is a dogfighting simulator. The only real hidden information is what is on your dial. That's one of the reasons, like, I should probably just say what I'm planning and what my dial is, but I'm just... It makes me uneasy, right? Just because I've played other games where cheating is abundant. But actually with X-Wing, everybody's so on the up and up, and if you forget something, they're more than happy to let you do it anyway, even if it's past the time, unless it's, like, significantly, right? But especially if it's, like, an automatic ability or something that's supposed to have triggered, everybody's pretty much like, oh, well, let's go back and redo it, because it should have happened. If it was a optional thing, then time's not on your side. Anyway, my build is, if you didn't get a chance to look at it too terribly much. Alright, now he's getting his stuff up. I have Echo with Agent Callus, Sensor Jammer, Veteran Instincts, and Advanced Cloaking Device, Captain Oiken, Kylo Ren, Palpatine, Seismic Torpedo, and Ion Projector. He's got some small little bitty guys. I'm going to go ahead and post the links in chat for the builds in case anybody is wanting to just have it up on their screen. I'd like to put it on the layout somewhere, but it's just not a great space to do it. There's so much involved. You know, I've got to have the map, I've got to have, you know, what we're discussing so that it's not so play-by-play from me, in case I forget something. Everybody can kind of follow along as it goes. It's not a great way to do it. Let's go ahead and start setting up some rocks, I guess. My thought on rocks is kind of set them up a little bit farther from his side, more close to my side, so that way when I start off, I don't have to worry about anything. I like to put it a little bit in from the corners. Just in case I need to cut that corner at some point during the game. Is it not nudging down? I think it's actually good though. Yeah. It's in. Tend to get sidetracked a little bit. I think I was mentioning that I'm matched up against a lot of players from other countries. So far France, and I think this guy's in... Well, he's somewhere else in Europe. Anyway, he's 8 hours ahead of me, so... Or maybe, I guess he's just seven. He said it's 7:20 there. Okay, he's set. He's throwing it in the corner. That's fine. I will take this guy, turn him a bit. He doesn't have any large ships, so I'm not too worried about placing asteroids and stuff close by. I'd more like to give myself some room to breathe. Gets to retake his target lock. Just double check that. Yeah, after attack, when attacking, immediately after you roll the attack dice, you may acquire a target lock if it already has a target lock on it, which both his other guys can acquire one. He also shoots first, so basically what it means is he can spend his own turn focusing. His own action. Actually, I'll take this little filler. Actually, do I want it there? I think I kind of want it offset a little. I don't like having things lined up too terribly much, so I'm confident in my own abilities most of the time, even though that confidence is sometimes is misplaced. Okay. So, as long as his other guys have a target lock, he gets a free one, because he'll shoot first. I think that means that I probably want to callous on him. Otherwise, everybody's the same. That's fine. So we got a little cluster right there, but other than that, we've got a pretty wide open map. Okay, I've got a 4, he's got a 5, so I place that first. 2, 3. We'll place him down on the corner here. This positioning is nice, it allows me to, kind of slow down a little bit. He doesn't know which side I'm gonna go on. And we're set. We'll see where he lines up. What's nice about his build as well, Echo is the top pilot skill. Echo gets to always shoot and then cloak before anybody else can say anything about it. It's really nice. I don't have to worry about using my Kylo in order to bring anybody down in pilot skill. I mean, they would go underneath Oiken, which is not always the best thing. Oiken likes to move first so he can make sure he rams people. Looks like he's lining up to come that way. So I can zoom up with Oiken. I can face him. See, everybody's so polite in X-Wing. It's a great hobby. If you're curious about what we're listening to, this is X-Wing versus TIE Fighter, I believe. No, Star Wars TIE Fighter. Old game. Ooh. Thought I did something, but it was switching tracks. We're good. Okay, looks like he's lining up everybody for Oiken. So that means Oiken's getting the heck out of there. They will make short work of him very, very quickly. By the time they get up here, well, they can do fives, I believe. Let's double check that. Yes, they can do fives, and a five is actually green, as crazy as that is. So they can go really fast. So we're, likewise, going to have to go really fast. Now, that being said, something we can do is try to ram. If we try to go away too much, that can cause us issues with them getting to us. Okay. Callus. On Messery. He's the ship that can do the most damage because of his free attack. Riot is not pleasant either, but that's mostly because of her repositioning, not necessarily from her strength. Alright, put that down here where I can see it and remember it. Put this stuff down here. Okay. Now Echo. What do I want to do with Echo? I'd like to offset Echo just a bit. Don't want him up there. Gives me a little more room to maneuver around. Make sure that I'm within range where I need to be. We're good. Okay. Anchor set. Good luck and have fun. Alright, so we're to dials now. So when we go to dials, it's the only hidden information we have from the opponent, is where we're gonna go. So my first thought with Oiken is to get away. Second thought is I can run in there and ram the crap out of him. Starting? Logging to. Okay, yeah, we're good. Okay. So, how do we want to roll this right off the bat? Vestry's on the bottom, which is fine. If he ends up staying around the longest, it just means Callus gets to stay in effect longer. not a lot of tricky stuff to this first move. No decloak this round, so that makes things a little bit easier as well. That's another nice thing about Oiken going first, is that I'm not dependent on him to remember that I'm decloaking. Alright. So here we go. Set. No decloak. I just like to say that at the front, even though there's no possible way. That I would possibly be decloaking, because I don't have the dope. But I like to remind people. Oh, I didn't bring up my list of hotkeys. I'll have to do that. Three right bank. Correct. And a focus. Set. I'm guessing he's doing at least threes, but I'm gonna guess fives. Let me also do this real quick. Chat. Oh, we don't need edit scene on either. Just in case we bump something. That's a chat. Oh, alright. I don't want to mess it up. So we're gonna leave it. I see that it's a little cut off, but... Oh, okay. Interesting, interesting. Curious bit of a move there. It's all good. Let me pull up my, come on. My hotkeys. So I have to bring up the menu. Doesn't look great. Okay, I'm doing a left bank, which is control 3. And we're gonna cloak, because of course we are. That's it. And that was the exciting round one. It's only like one ship that can actually get in range if it wants to by itself in turn one, and that's one of the new ships, the Shadowcaster from the Rebels TV show. Okay, so if they're going up that way, I think I have my next couple moves. Potentially. For Oiken, at least, because he's a little bit easier. Let's also reset actions. Okay, Echo, what do we want to do with you? Number of different directions. That's why I love Echo so much. So much. Okay. I think we'll do something like this. Decloaking. This off. We're going backward to the left. Back left. I should try to spell correctly. Okay. Gonna adjust this a little bit. Since I angle echo just slightly, it helps with both dodging arcs and getting people within them. I can go up just a little bit more. Good enough. Looks good. Zoom on out. Oiken. Another one forward. And a focus, because I can't target lock anybody. And we're set. Okay, just moving on up. All these quick moves get some a lot of tokens pretty fast. It's really useful for dice modification. Shrink this down here. I think in this game it's necessary to have facial hair. Gotta do a lot of musing. It really helps. Okay, Echo's turn. It's doing a right bank, which is Alt 2. Okay. And then let's see. Think through some cloaking, decloaking options. If I cloak, should think I might barrel roll. Barrel roll left and forward. Set. Still no shooting. Round two is over. Okay. So we're kind of trying to dodge an encounter until Echo can get in a decent position. He's got to make some choices, whether to break off and try to defend against Echo with somebody, or to just go all out for Oiken. And it's a hard choice to make. Oiken takes a while to go down if you don't put all guns on him. He's got a lot of health. Couple ideas of what I can do. Both would work. I'm not sure what puts me in a better position. I think we're gonna go with this. Bum bum ba da dun dun dun. Okay, turn four. Alright. Oh, they're all going four. Okay, turn. Okay. So, what this could mean is that he's gonna come in at Echo. Granted, that won't happen this turn. But the thing is, Echo can just cloak and back off if we need to. Okay, bank right three. And that's exactly what we can do with the cloak. And that's it. Dials again. It's a fairly slow moving match, and from what I understand about TIE Defenders, I haven't really played with them at all, or even against them, really. I just don't come across them. They recently got some new cards that make them a lot better, and I haven't really been able to play test it. Either myself running it or somebody else against me. But from what I understand, they like to keep the fight in one area, in where they believe the best area is for them to get into a fight. For Echo, Echo's very maneuverable. Echo can stay in the rocks. Echo doesn't mind. Now that's put me in some bad spots before, but that's on me. It's not on the ship. What are we going to do here? Because I definitely don't want to engage with Echo and get all guns on me. Echo's a glass cannon. Echo goes down really fast. It needs to isolate and destroy. So I think what we're going to do here is first hide my dials. I also need to remember I got sensor jammer, because I always forget that. Hope this clears. Actually, I could do something like that. I don't know if it's better or not. But again, it'll start putting him a little bit more on the defensive. Echo, what are you gonna do? I think that's a good choice. Okay. Just thinking through other options. I think that puts me a little too close in. I think what I've got's pretty good. Confident in Echo's ability to take any small base ship with no like turret or anything like that one-on-one. I mean, aside from me making some kind of blunder, it's a pretty good matchup. Anyway, any ship doesn't really matter. It's the turrets and stuff that really get to Echo. It's hard to dodge a turret. 360 degree arc, you can't. You can shoot them, they can shoot you. But with these defenders, they only have the front-facing arc, and that's it. I might even bump that up a little bit. trying to figure where that'll put me, though. Okay. He's set, I'm set, we're all set. Decloak misspelled because... who cares? Uh-oh, I should declare. I'm going back to the left. It's something I need to work on too. I've been just like lately, like just plopping it down, because I figure if I just face it the right way and plop it down, of course, that's the way I was intending. But with things like a league or a tournament or something, you kind of want to make sure everything's on the up and up. Okay. Is that weakened? Hopefully this is not a bad move. It's bank left 3. Control 3. Okay. Whew. That was close. Very close. Almost getting into Kylo range. Now Kylo, not the best against these guys, I will say. What I could do is like give them blind pilot where they cannot shoot. Everybody's going to. Set, okay. 3, right turn. Alt shift 3. Okay, we're going to. It's pretty far out. It's possible that they're too far. This is part of the hard part, right, with Echo, where you're like, okay, well, if they're too far, I need to cloak now. But if I can shoot at them, granted, I'll probably miss, but if I can shoot at them, but if I don't, that's what we have to think of. We have to think of the bad thing happening. If the bad thing happens, where does that put us? Could very well be out of range. And if we have to take one shot from Vessery with just a focus at range 3, cloaked, it's 5 dice. Against 3 dice. With focus, but, you know, not bad. But it means that next turn we don't have to fly straight into him. So we're gonna cloak. Set. Oh no, I definitely could have got him. Shot. And that was a solid range 3 too. It wasn't even barely. Ooh, at least he can't shoot me. But that would have been a free shot. That would have been nice. Oh, that was close too. I definitely didn't think she would have one, but man, that was close. And missed a free shot. That is nice positioning though. Look at that. That green just hovering right around. I'll take it. Dials again. Wiccan, big boy, what you wanna do? Okay, Echo. That's the big question. What do you want to do? Echo's nice because he keeps people honest. They have to really account for anywhere he could go. There's 6 decloaking options, all of which change the firing arc and the direction of travel. And then there's the slim possibility that I don't decloak, right? I've done it before. The one thing to make sure you keep with Echo is just now and then sprinkling in some unpredicted moves. So if he turns in at me, which way do I want to go? If I knew I could get around that rock without taking some kind of beating or landing on it, I think I could get by without landing on it, but I think I would hit it. And I want my action if I'm gonna maybe be involved in what could be 3-shit attack. But again, it's hard. It's hard. You wanna go in, but at the same time, you need to play it safe. It's a tough ship to master. I've been working on it, because I think, in my opinion, it's one of the strong ships. Everybody plays the pilot that's one up from Echo, which is Whisper. But Whisper uses a straight template to decloak. Makes it so much more predictable. I hate it. I can't even fathom not being able to do all this funky stuff. I think I could get around that rock, but because I don't know it. That would be nice. It'd be a nice move. Tough. Tough. I could go in with my decloak. I can go forward with it. And then hope that I'm only taking a couple shots. There's no way to guarantee. If he does like a 4K or something, could be just as screwed. Looks like he's set. I'm set. Everybody's set. Set the cloak. Spelled wrong again. Alright. My positive, that's what I want to do. No. It's the safe thing. Gosh darn it. Back. Right. Actually, I'm kind of curious if I could have made that just real quick. I think I could have. But... I had to play it safe, you'd never know. Okay, how far up do I want to be? I think this should be fine. He comes in at me though. At least right end viscera, you'll have a shot. It's just dangerous. You never know. Good there. Zooming down out. Awaken. Hard left 3. Control shift. Eventually I'll end these hotkeys. Nice. We're good there. We didn't hit. We're going to attempt. I think he's too far. We'll attempt. I could throw Kylo on, but I don't really want to Kylo the Glaive Wing. Oh, he's just out. I can even tell without zooming in, but we'll zoom in just because. Yeah. Focus. Set. Okay, he did come in. If I had gone around that rock. Oh, that would be amazing. I wasn't sure. This isn't gonna be pretty. They don't have Juke, but they do have Crackshot. Oh, interesting. Alright, I mean, I should hopefully be at range 3. I'll evade, but, you know, still not pretty. Okay, I did left 1, control shift 1. Okay. This is another part of the game, too, where it's like, okay, well, what I could do is barrel roll. It gets me out of a few arcs. I have Palpatine, I have an evade, I could have an evade token, I'll be cloaked. I don't know if I'm range 2, but I hope I am. Or I hope I'm 3, rather. So I guess we're going to evade. And hopefully we'll be okay. They only have focus tokens. No target locks yet. Finally, time for some lasers. Okay. I could definitely barrel roll out of Riot's Arc. Maybe out of Vessery's. Shoot. If Vessery still has a shot, I should still be okay. Shift C. I'm gonna barrel roll. It's just I'd rather take one shot potentially than two, even if odds are on my side. Okay. We actually barrel roll forward because the arc is smaller since it's cone shaped. Alright, I think I'll still be in Vessery's, and that'll stink, but I'll be rolling 4 dice with Palpatine. Okay, range 2. this down here. Bum 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 ba-da-ba-dum. Okay. Man, am I still in Riads? I'm just waiting, let me look. I hope Riad doesn't nick our back corner. That would defeat the whole purpose of barrel rolling. That's why we went forward. Try to negate some of that conage. Going for Vessery. He's the closest shot. He's also the most aggressive guy. Gets that free target lock potential. Decide before showing it. I mean, when we haven't progressed past the step, it doesn't seem like the big steal. Four to three. Sounds right. Like, it's not like I measured a target lock, right? When you do something like that where you're actually measuring things, you have to take it. If you can. Rolling four. Oh, wow. I'm not quite sure how to spell holy moly, but we're gonna go with that. Holy moly. We'll be set. I don't really even want to put in a crit for just that reason. Nicely done. Well, that's why we didn't palp that. I'm going to cloak. So rolling four with Palpatine. Really hoping that Riad is out of our... we're out of Riad's arc. Next round, Oiken will be in here and that'll get a lot better. Spend his focus on that roll too. Hit blank focus. May as well spend the focus. Yep. So two. Should be easy enough. If we can at least evade one, we'll be okay. Rolling four. There's two. Good enough. And we're out. That was close. Okay. Boykin. I don't think he's out, but we'll check it. Yeah. Nope. So, I mean, it's one of those things with the, like, the phase progression and stuff like that. Like, we weren't out of the phase, right? As far as me switching actions, I hadn't measured anything. But if that's how we're gonna play it, then I guess that's how we'll play it. I mean, it's fine. I don't have to put that, or, you know, actually pushing buttons to hit that out there, but, you know, you could, I don't know, it's fine, either way. Okay, so what do we want to do here? I think we get Oigen just in the fight. But there's a couple ways we can do it. We can turn and broadside. We'll be more limited in our moves after that. Echo. So now he's got choices, right? He has to decide whether he comes after Echo or he turns and shoots after Awaken. Awaken some guaranteed damage. Echo, you might not even have an arc. Okay, well, what we could do here is, where would that put us? I'm trying to think. 45 degrees would put us facing that direction, I believe. He's working with here. He's got everything but a one straight. Seems decent enough. So he's either gonna turn left or right. Going straight doesn't help him. K-turning also doesn't help him. Unless I'm gonna fly in there, I guess. That's true, though, isn't it? Actually, that's very true. I thunk a thought. I hope it's good, but it may be not. Bum bum ba da da, bum bum ba da da, bum bum. Right. Cloak. I'm going back. Right. Hopefully this was a good idea. Down. Boykin. Coming in hot. Alright. Going to. I think we actually target lock? I don't think we want a Kylo right now. Target lock. Vessery. Dun 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 dun. Okay. My thought is whichever way he chose to go, straight would be not the greatest. Huh? Land right on that. I think I'm still good as far as she goes. Okay. Oh, he was trying to cover his bases a little bit. Okay. It's good for me. Set, okay. Echo. Just gonna add hard right one. Or hard left one, sorry. Control shift one. Okay. So I think he's in Riad's arc right now, so I can't stay here. Ooh, it's close though. I could be out. If I'm out, that's awesome. Be cloak, but that'd be a four dice attack with focus. But man, I very well could be out of that. I think I want to say I am. I want to say I am. This is dangerous, but we're going to focus. Here we go. Okay. Range one. Yeah, buddy. Yes. Rolling five against three. Okay. I think we Palpatine one of these. He can't roll that good again. But at the same time, if he rolls, King on Palp, so he doesn't roll. He's got three shields. I could save Palp for Oiken's defense or Oiken's attack. I think I'd do that. And I save it also for... I also save that for... That could have been nice. And he still debates all of it, though. Okay, I'm gonna cloak. Now he has nothing with which to evade Awaken, except for he might be range 3. Probably is. Let's hope we're at a riot. Oh yes, oh yes. So we can get to one dice. We can palp it if we need to. Just to save us one hit. Two, if you want to spend that. Okay, it does. Which means we're taking one. Come on, evade. Not an evade. Okay, so I could just take the two and hope that I hit Vessery. I have a target lock. I think I'll take the two. Yes. All right. So we're good there. So now, got a range 3 shot. Or both rolling 4 dice, but Riot has an evade. Vessery is also target locked. So we're gonna go after Vessery, and we're gonna hope for the best. Three dice. Oh, we don't even have to, but we're gonna palp one just because. It won't matter in the end. Oh, just because. What's that? Round 7. This very well could go to the time limit, which I think is 19. Nice thing here is Riad is going over the debris. Which, hold on. That flew right past me. Flew being the pun. I mean, it's technically too late at this point. I should have pointed out earlier, but I didn't think about it. You know, so if he chooses to take it, it's kind of up to him. It's the right thing to do, but at the same time, it's past the step. Some people would be like, well, it doesn't matter now. We're just gonna plan on him not taking stress and stuff. Well, he's going for it. That's nice of him. Technically, I probably couldn't hold him to it because it's past the step. But it's one of those things where shield for it. You know, that's one of the things about this game is the community is pretty stinking awesome. Makes us live a little bit longer. Granted, Riad still has a ton of greens. Can K-turn with the green, clear that stress, but the thing is, Riad's gonna get that stress right back when it flies over it again. I don't think it has a move that's gonna clear it, except maybe a one hard turn, but a run hard turn is red. Yes, so she can't do that. Even if she wanted to. Okay. So, with that being the case, how do we want to play this? in this kind of lull. Okay, so I got a Awakens move, Echo. What do we want to do with you? So Vessery could flip around with 4. Glaive Squadron might be able to do 4, but maybe not. And the way he's kind of hedging his bets a little bit, that's good for us. Dies on the table, man. It's all good. We're not set yet. If I do that, what am I going to be facing that way? Okay, I think of my first thought was right. Cloak, back, left. Probably what he thought I was gonna do, but yeah, there's only so much and hide sometimes. Left one. Control one. And we're going to focus and be set. We'll see. Ryad might bump into us. She might get a range one shot. Depends on. Nope, 5. Nope, a bump, and that she's still pointed the same way she doesn't want to be. That's good for us. She gets that stress, she's got to roll again. I have a second document. I don't need that. That's good, that's good. Roll because obstacle. And projector. I'm gonna palp it. Just to make sure she goes one straight next time. Just kind of takes her out of the fight for a minute, you know. Gutsy. Two bank would have been nice to do. Well, actually, maybe not. Target lock on Echo. Oh, nope. Haha, just out. Can't. Darn right. Down there. Target lock awaken. Surprised you didn't do that a long time ago. I might still be in Vestry's Ark. Hopefully, if nothing else, I'm range 3 and that'll help. I think I got away from the glaive. I hope. Okay, Riot's got no defense. Range 2. Rolling 4. No Palpatine. No focus. It's just a roll on a roll. Two crits. I can't use callus. Set. One of eight, so one more shield. That's good. Little by little. I should probably throw down a chit for the ion because I have a feeling that it could get forgotten. One shield, echo, cloak. Got five dice. I'm that far away from Vessery, I should be good from the glaive. If it's a two, we might as well. Come on, baby, come on, baby. Oh, callus. Callus. Callus saved my bacon. Splitting up damage way too much, but I gotta take the shots I have, you know? There's nothing else I can do. Rolling three. Ion projector. Forgot about it, I guess. Alright, rolling three. That's all I got. Set. Okay. Just... just a little. Oh, I guess I could have used my focus. I don't know, it didn't even matter. But probably should have. Would have been the smart thing to do. Okay, how do we want to play this one? It'll be out of the fight. We don't have to worry about her. Awaken. What do I want from you, buddy? What do I want you to do? Echo, how do we want to play this? Oh, I could do that as well, couldn't I? It's a conundrum, isn't it? that's probably the way to go. Not thrilled with it. If I did something like that, that could work though. That could work. Now put me. I think alright. Try it. That being the case, though, maybe I need a weekend to do that. It's gonna be tight. It's gonna be tight. And I don't mean that's gonna be awesome. I have no guarantee of that. Set decloak forward. Oh. I want to say, decide before you put your dials down and say you're set. You know, kind of like my evade token, but we'll let it go. Straight with us on the debris, so we're gonna trust. It's hard to do though. All good. Curse me for being tight-tongued. Decloak. Forward. Left. Hoping I actually have an arc on here when it's all said and done. Two. Left. Bank. I should. I hope that Oiken's going fast enough, or at least won't collide. Two left bank. Control two. Come on, buddy, clear. Just barely. Okay. That's good for us. Echo should be okay. We're going to focus. Now we gotta focus target lock. Set. Okay, here we go. One forward from the ion. Can delete that sucker. I know she's ioned, and it's fantastic. 4K turn. Ooh, okay. We might be out of his arc. Maybe. Maybe not. We'll see. We'll find out. It's hard to say. His name echoes right through the firing arc. Okay, let's see what Vestry does. If Vestry goes fast, he collides and he ions. That'll be good. That's what I was kind of hoping for. Alright. Okay, he's trying to get me an arc. Forward as possible. That's actually good for us. In a way, if he had gone backwards, Echo might have been an arc. 4K turn, which he won't be flipping around, he'll be going straight. That part's bad for us. Rolling for Ion. What's good is that he doesn't get his focus. I think he still gets his evade, though. Which is collided. I don't have a shot, so that's not really a problem. Do I palp that or do I not? Thing is, I'm gonna have a really nice shot at Vestry. I won't palp it. Oh gosh, that's tough though. I think I want to save the palp for the shot. No palp. Now it's all about clearing. Gotta clear with this turn. Alt shift one. I'm hoping we're good. Yes. Okay. So. I think we focus here. The thing is, Vestry does have a shot because he went straight ahead. Probably should have palped that shot, but man, I'm just... don't want it. Okay. Do we think we can get by with a barrel roll? Where's that arc gonna be? I think we're gonna get caught in the arc anyway. So we don't want a barrel roll. I don't think we're range one. Oh, we could be, though. Man. Makes it tight, though. We have Kallus, we have Palpatine. We'll be rolling four against maybe four. That's not great odds. But his are unmounted. I think we have to focus. I don't want to. Or, I mean, evade. I really don't want to. Pretty sure we're safe against the Glaive Squadron, so it's just the one shot. We gotta play it safe, man. Okay. We did what we intended, but we kind of blocked ourselves into a bad shot. But it's just one, so hopefully we'll be alright. Rolling five. We do have Palpatine. Ooh, that's really nice. It's tough. Do I use Palpatine? I think I do. Could mean death. It could mean death. We gotta go for it. Palp. Nice. That's three. Two of those are gonna be criticals. One could be a double damage. Two crits. Let's cloak before we forget that sucker. What do we got? Let me pull up my crit list so I can see it. Bum bum bum, bum bum bum. Console fire. And weapons failure. That's both good. One less attack. And I think the possibility of one damage. Console fire. Roll one attack die on a hit, suffer damage. Oh, he's pasting them. Okay. Good, because that will bring up ads. We don't want that. Okay. Suffer damage. He has to spend an action there. And then his weapons are down, so he has to spend an action there. He's got some hard choices to make. Oiken could take her out as well. I think it was a good thing we palped that, or else it would have just been one crit, and those are both pretty good. Bring it. Four versus zero. It's fine. Oh, and he didn't focus. What the heck? Oh man. But you needed the barrel. One shield. That could have been a lot worse. Come on, range two. Oh yes, good. Okay. Whew. Close. Okay, I'm rolling four. I got an evade. No Palpatine. But I do have Kallus. Nasty. Rolling four. Kallus. That was close. Oiken. Alright buddy, bring it home. Riad. I zoomed out way too far, or zoomed in. Riad. Rolling three with a focus. And I will use it. This should be lights out for Riad. Done. She's gone. She's a slippery one, so she's nice to knock out. Alright. First blood is ours, which is really good. Awaken needs to survive to do some damage. Okay. Dials. Pretty straightforward. No pun intended. Okay. Echo. How do we want to play? He's gonna go fast with Vessery. I mean, he's got to, or else he runs the risk of ramming me again and potentially getting that ion. So he's got to go fast with Vessery. He can't turn. He could turn right, but that's not to his purposes. So he's got to go fast, which means he's going to be going straight. More than likely. He could 3-bank. And probably get by. He'll be taking damage. That's just, it goes without saying. So, the question is, how do we get Echo away safely? I think... Is that bathroom? Okay. So I got a moment to think, that's good. I almost think we should do... He could K-turn and come back at Awaken. That's also a possibility. If he flies fast, I'll be in Arc, I think, if I do that. I think. Maybe not. But it's not the smartest thing to do. Let's be smart. I can go that way. I think we'll be fine. The glaive, what's the glaive gotta do? I don't think it can turn left or right, I mean, at all. Left is bad, so it can really only go straight. K-turn, it'd probably K-turn. I might be able to dodge that debris, but at the same time I might be able to just go that way. Okay, I think if he 3-banks that could be bad. I think we do this. It's not perfect. It's just okay. Ooh, that's set. Oh, he doesn't. No, he doesn't. That would have been bad if he thought that. Let's see. I think this could be a safe move. It seems risky, but I think it actually could be safe. I'm hoping. Hoping. Set. Decloak. Forward left. I'm gonna go as far as I can, I think. Okay. Boykin. Forward one. He doesn't go anywhere. Bump for damage on this. Brings me down to one shield, that's nice. I mean, he had to see that coming, that's pretty obvious. Bump it down. 4K turn, that's what I figured you were gonna do, buddy. So I figured you were gonna do. Although it didn't put him as far as I thought it would. I could have just right turned. Probably would have been the smartest thing to do. Instead, actually where he's positioned, I don't even know if I'll have him mark. That could be bad. Oh, Awaken's about to take a nasty shot. If I don't hit him, this could be bad. Target lock and Awaken. Smart thing for him to do. He hasn't worked this pilot ability in yet. He's finally doing it. It's not good. Set. I don't think this is gonna work actually. Alt control 4. Ugh, I don't think so. I mean, it would be great if he's in arc, but I don't know if he is. I might nip the corner of him. Turned. Come on, baby. Do I nick him? Do I nick him? No, I don't think I do. No. No, I'm pretty sure I don't. I see some blue. Curses. Turn off the arc, buddy. You missed. There we go. Alright, not the greatest thing ever. Kind of frozen up, though. Okay, this is where I might take some pain. 4-0. There's some pain. Wait. What are we waiting for? Target lock. I don't know why you yelled at me to wait, but alright. Target lock, yeah. Four, three, two shields. One, two. Hit. And another hit. Okay. Let's pull these off the double damage deck. One. And here we go. Guess he wants to see both of them now, doesn't he? flipping it. Stunned pilot. Not a great one. Especially for Oiken that wants to run into people. This is usually the card I put into people. Alright, he's got it. So, I guess we're good. How many shields you had? Alright, here we go again. Oh man! Ouchie. Alright, 1, 2, 3 and a crit again. 1, 2, 3, 4. Well, he's got half points now. It's not great. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Flip it, direct hit. It's one more. Alright, not great. Not great. Okay, so no more bumping for him, I guess. Well, you've had plenty of good shots. They just haven't connected. Okay. Oiken, what are we gonna do with you, buddy? Oiken. Well, he gets attack. Okay, they both have an evade, so I guess we go for Vessery. He's the stronger one. Vess, and he's the weaker one, if I happen to get lucky. Rolling 4. Chances to hit is the same, so I might as well go for the weak guy. And Palpatine. Come on, baby. Come on, baby. Evade, evade, blank, and his evade token. Crap. Okay. Should start thinking a bit longer term. Maybe throw Kylo on somebody. Pretty much ready. I'm gonna hit the bathroom real quick again. That's a problem with drinking. So his styles, what's he gonna do? He can turn in with the glaive. But I think I could dodge his arc if I needed to. With a barrel. Vessery, probably gonna K-turn. The other option he has is to come in at Wigan. Keep chasing him down. He's only got 5 hits left. Actually, I think he could do this and get away with it. Ah. Way too many windows for this game. On the tabletop, it's awesome. But it does get a little bit cluttered. I think I'm set. Vessery only has a 4K, which he could do. He's gonna be pretty far away. But I don't think he comes at Echo, I think he tries to chase down Wigan. And if he does, I think I'll be alright if I go this way. Wigan. Alright, too. Alt Shift 2. Oops. That's what I pushed. Alt Shift 2. Alt. Oh no, I pushed Alt Control. That would do it. Okay, and we're gonna focus. Okay, set. Bank left. That's right. I figured he thought I would go that way. But he can barrel roll. But that means he's weaker. Also means he might crash into me with his glit or into himself with the glaive. Thinking. Which he could use to a disadvantage if he did it right. Pretty sure he's gonna barrel roll. Just makes sense. He did a 3 left. Okay, so he's splitting up, coming in Echo. He's trusting Vessery to do it himself. I'm curious. He should get Wigan and Arc. But Wigan won't be dead, so there's that. Set, okay. 2 left bank. Okay, now, Do I think a barrel roll could get me out of this? Kinda do. Shift S, I think it's Control Shift? Yeah. Okay. It's a nasty shot to take. I think I need to barrel roll. Barrel roll right. Do that. Where is that gonna put me? I might be out of a shot if I do. But, man, I'm taking an awful chance. If I went backwards, that might give me a shot. And kind of get me some distance. Roll right. That might make me safe. Control D, okay. Okay. Shoot both. Both are range 2. Vessery only has a focus. Against Vess, I got Palp, I got Callus on my side, so I'd still have some mods. Oh, you jerk. Alright, we're gonna Callus, and I think we're gonna Palp. Callus. Blanks, beautiful, beautiful. Take all the damage. Take it all. Please be a double. Please be a double. Please be a double. If it's a double damage, we're in business. Thrust control fire, so that's a stress. Not a huge deal. Okay. Does mean though that he's still at 1 health. Oiken could take him down. And Oiken has a target lock and a focus to use. Really was hoping for a direct hit, buddy. Oh yes, Echo got out of there. Nice. Oh, he barely nicks it. I thought he would be in it a little bit more. He barely nicks it. Look at that. It's pretty darn close. Okay. If he uses it, he won't have it for defense. He used it. He used to focus on defense. Defense deck. Set, okay, well, that's a 1-2 and a crit. 1-2-3. Bam. Should still be alive, so it's not the hugest issue. A stress, okay. Also not terrible, because if I can take down Vessery, we'll be, I think we'll be alright. Okay. Oh man, so close to range one. So close. Zooming in, but I think we're out. Zooming in even more. All the way. Oh. Man. That is so close. I can't. If the background would stay red, it would be a lot easier to tell. I can't say decisively that it is, though. I might nick the very tip, but I couldn't say with any certainty. Looks like two, man. Imperial. I could do this, too. If I zoom in. If it didn't mean the end of his biggest, baddest ship, might not care. Okay, let's go from corner to his corner. So close. Alright, rolling three. I already used Palpatine. And I have my focus. Set. If he can't dodge on all, we're good. Looks like it. Can't click on there to type. Come on. Catch up, game. Come on, buddy. Wiccan has a stress, but that's not super terrible right now. More worried about getting away from the edge of the board. Okay, Echo, what do we want to do with you? We want to do what he's not expecting. What is that? I can go left or I can go right. This way. Not the greatest move, but it's gonna be hard. Well, shoot. Actually, if he K turns, it's bad. Muy malo. I think I'm better off going that way and turning in this way. The wrong buttons, that's why. Like, why am I going that direction? Actually, actually. Shoot. I keep second guessing myself. Triple guessing, I guess. Set decloak. We're going right and forward. Where do we want to go back now? Back could be good too. Forward. It's not often the same move works both ways. If he heart turns at me, he's got to do it pretty darn tight, which is gonna be a stress. Awaken. Stay on the board, buddy. Right heart three. Still stressed though. Set. Hard left. Okay, he chose the right direction for me. But I think I'm gonna be out of his arc. This game's been going for quite some time. I think we started at like 12:30 or so. Well, I guess the play didn't start until maybe 45. But either way, it'd be well past time. Barrel roll left, that's a good idea for him. Okay. Good idea. Okay, barrel rolling, turning left. That's not good at all, is it? Okay. So, let's think about options. We can barrel roll left and get... farther away. Not out of arc, but farther away. Range 3? I don't know about that. We might be safer just to... cloak, have 4 dice, and Palpatine on our side. I think that's what we're gonna do. Sit. Four on four. He doesn't have any offensive modification now. I need at least 2. If I can get 2, I can Palpatine the other one. That's bad. whole game I haven't used sensor jammer because I haven't needed it. This would be a time it would come in handy. Blast. Well, I can dodge one with Palp. Oops. Oh, evade. At least it's only shields, but it still sucks. I could still have a shield left. Alright, Boykin, you better make this worth it. He's not gonna. He's not gonna. I already had to use Palpatine, so it's just a naked 3 dice. One and a crit. He's got all full health, full shields, and an evade token. That's all I can do. Set. Let's look at my dials. And he evades it all. Of course he do. Okay. Alright, next. I'm gonna actually move my sensor jammer down here too so I can see it. Okay, I think I actually do this. Still cuts off some options. Echo, what are you gonna do, buddy? I think he 4Ks. I think that's really his best bet. Otherwise, he can turn right or left. Left is very not effective for him. Right, I'm not gonna be there, so. Should be able to do that. I don't think he has a way to shoot the decimator. I'm struggling to think of one. So I think even a 2 is gonna ram. Set decloak. Yeesh. Left forward. see, if we Kylo and Blinded Pilot, he can't attack if we get a crit in. I think that's the way to go. Hopefully he bumps into us and gets ioned. That would be perfect. But I think he hit. He did hit. Well, that's that. But I'm hoping so. Okay, it's gonna be a good one. Ion roll. Come on, baby, come on, baby. Ioned. Not a lot he can do at this point. If I hadn't hit, I probably would have pumped it just to get it in there. It's really a big thing right now. Okay, ion. Okay. Just want to make sure he's caught up there in control shift one. And we're going to focus. This went from close to really bad for him. Okay. Level 5. Palping. Critting. Palp. I think we're in trouble. Okay, I don't think there's a way we can bump, but there might be. Thank you. think we can, actually. I think we can. Okay, Echo, what do we do with you? I think we might have to use our thing on a barrel roll, though. Maybe. This way. This is getting way too close. Where would that put him? A 1-4 would put him pretty much at the end of Waken, wouldn't it? I don't know if he could make it out of that. I don't think he clears this. Bank right one. Oh crap, does he? He does. Well, I guess he target locks. He could make it out of there. It's going to be a stressful move, but he could do it. Okay. Barrel roll. He's going to barrel roll backward. It'd be all right. Okay. Control shift one. There's blue in there. Okay, focus. Gotta go on the offense here. Range 2. 4 dice. We spend the focus. One, so that's all his shields. That's nice. That's good. I think it's actually 2 shields, 1 crit. Range 1 with the target lock and Palpatine. Target lock and Palpatine. Let's clear our action. Clear our target lock. Evade, evade, blank. That's it. Should be it, right? No, that's only 2. 1 crit. 1 shield, 1 crit. He's down to 1 hole. Damage cockpit. Pilot skill 0. Not a big deal. Man, this is taking forever. Dials, what do I want Echo to do? Probably. Let's see. It's hard because I don't know which way he's going to turn. We can set Echo. I don't want to get too gung-ho with Echo though either. is the best thing to do. There's not really a great move, because I don't know where he's going to go. Set decloak. Left back. I think we can be alright to move. Hopefully I don't crash into myself, because he takes damage now. Hard right. Thought he might go right. Probably should have gone faster with Awaken. Okay, hard right two. Yeah, I did it accurately that time. Safe there. I'm gonna target lock. TL. Echo. Actually gonna bump. Doesn't really go anywhere. Alt shift. It's really not going anywhere. Looks good enough to me. Okay. Range two. Two? Yeah. Only three. Only needed one. Target lock. Wow. I guess we pelt it. Well, pelt, I guess. If I had only focused. And he got it. He only got the one. Oh my goodness. This game sometimes, I tell ya. Okay. I can try to turn Awaken around, but... Let's see, he's gotta do green. Does he have a green hard turn? No, he does not. So if he wants a hard turn in at me, he's gonna have a heck of a time. Okay. Should have gone fast with the Awaken until I get Echo to turn in. I just wasn't sure which way he was going to go, so I didn't want to put my eggs in a basket, but I think it would have been best either, even if it went the other way. He's just gonna run. Kinda thought he might. Target lock, I'm not sure why. One. Target lock. Nope. So I guess he's gonna focus, not that it matters. And one right. And we're gonna barrel roll. Okay, it's gonna evade. I don't have anything but Palpatine. Range 2, though. Range 2. 4 dice. And a Palpatine. You gotta be kidding me. Okay. What do we do here? Something like that. I can catch up to him in the next turn if I don't get him now. I should probably hide these. Cloak Ford. Thank you. just gonna keep the decimator safe. It doesn't need to get into things. If he wants to come in at me, that's fine. It's up to him. For his attack, I will be rolling 5 dice with focus. Set, I think. Yeah, gotta play it safe. Yeah, I wouldn't have mattered anyway, so it's a good thing we did. Alright, 5 dice. Yep, see, I needed it. 5. Are you kidding me? Gotta be kidding me. Palp. I think he does a 3 bank at me. That's what I think. Do I have a counter to that? Not really. Force him to go slower. Thing is, if he K turns, I want to do a 1. If he doesn't, I don't think he will, though. We forgot crack shot. Forgot crack shot the whole game. Here's hoping. Ford 5. Where was he thinking of going? We can bank left. I'm just gonna be clicking through so I can get done with this. It's been a really long game. 1 left turn. Focus. Come on, baby, be the end. Be the end. Range 2. Come on. Pound it. Yeah, you jerk. It's crazy. Okay. So, I meant to click this thing. Fantastic. Right is bad also. Shoot. Shoot, that was a terrible choice of maneuver. Sigh, come on. Yeah, I bet you are. 3 left turn. And there's blank. Right turn. I think if I barrel roll, I think I get out of there. Let me look here. Maybe so. I don't know. Right as back as possible. Please be out. Oh gosh. Sensor jammer, Palpatine. Sensor jammer, Palpatine, come on. Sensor jammer, Palpatine. Sensor jammer. This game is way too intense. Let's see. I'm trying to think of ways to mitigate. Glaive with crank shot is 1 plus. It's minus 2, so it's 29, I think. I could run, which is probably actually not a bad option, because I'm not going to get a shot on him. You'd have to do something not the smartest. I could do something not the smartest too, though. Oh, I should probably change awaken. that too, though. That could be bad if he goes... Shoot, there's not a great thing to do here. Set. Bank right 3. That's good. That's very good. I hope that's really good, but it might only be kind of good. Set. 1. I think he's got me an arc. I gotta kill him. Okay, it's not so good. 4 dice, come on baby, 4 dice. I've been rolling terrible for a while. Give me a good one. Range 2. Come on, Palpatine. Shoot. Urgh. I gotta save Palpatine, right? Well, no, not necessarily. He's gotta do 1 hit. 3 against 2, I got nothing to change anything. Help to go, guys. Set. Freaking A. I've gotta make a set attempt to save Echo. Two. He would have evaded it, so it's good. I just need 1. Give me 1. Oh, jammer. Jammer, jammer, jammer. No, he used focus, so jammer doesn't count. I need 1. I need 1. Well. Gosh darn. Should have done the 1 turn. Crashed into him or something. Thank you. What's that? Alright. Last move lost it for me, man. Let me do this just to see. 4K. Yeah, turn it up. Good. Good set of matches. Or good. It was a good match. Good stuff. We'll be back again when I get another schedule. Take it easy.